Welcome back, my amazing lizard friends. Welcome back to Grim Dawn. We survived the Christmas holidays. And now we're preparing for the end of the year. And in Grim Dawn, we're actually preparing for the end of the world. Because last time we found out what's actually going on here. And we found out that this cultists of Thorn, that the sacrificed thorns and thorns of blood to their weird god thingy. Their plan is to create a new world and the old one with some crazy plan and revoking some evil, what is the god thingy, whatsoever. It's completely complicated. But that's the ultimate plan at the end. And we are going to stop this. We're going more to the north. We're in Homestead still. Our plan is to go more to the north, to this area that is like a snow place whatsoever, where we were last time. We were, here. Darkwell Gate. We found the rift at the Astakan Road. We are trying to reach Fort Icon now. Yeah, and it looks like the end of the map, to be honest. We were at Darkwell Gate, we were in the mountains. That's where we ended last time. Here was like a bit of a valley, Tomb of the Archon, and Fort Icon, that's where we're going to go. And here's the Necropolis, where the cultists tried to reach their ultimate goal. Yeah, we have still some stuff here in Gloomwald. But that seems to be maybe already on the way to Malmuth, what is the expansion for DLC. So, and we still have the Corvan Basin, but I'm pretty sure that's also the second DLC. Whatever with the gods and stuff. So, yeah, this is basically, I guess, close to the end of the main game. But before we go there, we still have to go back to the place of the Death Ritual's Order. Because they wanted to revoke one of their guys. I'm not that sure though where we have to go for this. Is it here? So, Bastion? I think so. Yeah, out of that special entrance. We are supposed to bring the whatsoever we collected, the seals of binding, we are supposed to bring them back so that they can reawaken one of the guys that died in some tragic occurrence. But he was one of the main important leading head figures of the order, so that's why they want him back. They said already they can't bring him back in his normal form with a body and all, but they can bring him back somehow as a type of a ghost or something maybe. We'll find that out now. Have you gathered the Chthonic seals? Are these the seals you see? I think so. Got iron and reputation. Yes, these appear to be in good shape. They will be most useful in returning Malkadar to this world. Next, we will require a source of arcane power. I have just a thing in mind. What's next? The Rite of Resurrection requires powerful incantations and an equally powerful energy source. Without something to draw upon, the ritual would drain the participants dry and leave them as nothing but withered husks. How can we prevent that? Ethereals are a manifestation of the Aether itself, a source of pure arcane energy. The more powerful the Ethereal, the hotter its spirit will burn within the ritual. To the north, near Fort Heron, there's a mine called Stone Rent Quarry that's become blasted with Aether fire, a front for the Ethereals in this region. Travel there and track down an Ethereal by the name Noveria Stormfire. She was once a great sorceress, now no more than a pawn of the Ethereals. I will bestow a boon of the order upon you to help counter her arcane prowess and to contain her essence. Destroy Noveria in the order's name. Okay. Sounds fun. We got now... What did we get? Your weapons are enchanted by the order. That's nice. we have... Ah, yeah, we got a new level. So to the north, the place called Fort Heron. Who could that be? Ah, here. Haven't we been there already? I think we've been there already, no? Cover, collect the Tyrael Essence, bring the Tyrael Essence back. Then we do this first, because I'm pretty sure we have been there already. But for some reason not fought against the Tyrael or something. So, yeah, we have to go there first. Okay, yeah, we got a new level. More spirit. I found out in the last episode, after the last records, I found out two things that are kind of shocking, because I could have known them already in a long time. I found out that we can actually craft dynamite. That is pretty embarrassing. We just need ether shards that we can create from ether crystals. So we just need 3 ether crystals to create an ether shard, and from this we can create dynamite. That is pretty embarrassing. Could have known that already a long time ago. And I found out that I have a second skill line here. That's also pretty embarrassing. Could have used that already a long time. But okay, that's how it is, I guess. That's as smart as I can get. And I also have no skills to give. But I kinda still want to max out the necromancer first. Before we even think of anything else. So, what is this? Mark of Torment, though all must ultimately answer to final fate, your mastery of death has allowed you to delay the inevitable. By linking your soul to a nearby foe, you transfer some of the harm intended for you into them. That's interesting. Bones of the dead fragment and absorb the souls of your foes, empowering you and your minions with the power of death. Soul harvest affects all attacks and pets while active. Cold damage, vitality damage, okay, bonus to our pets, oh, that's nice, actually pretty much, oh, and I get even flustered already, so, yeah, but yeah, it's just that. I really want to go to the ultimate abilities here, that's my ultimate goal, but it takes a bit of more time, of course. So now we go to the port. Hakon, whatsoever, that we think it's this one. We have been there already, I know that. I can pretty much remember this. Because, yeah, we have been there and we found there this other order, the religious fanatics. I think maybe do we need this rift or this rift? This rift could be a bit... Ah, that's inside the gate. It's kind of far. Maybe we use this rift. The other one is kind of far from that. And let's see, we have to fight through a lot of shit anyway. Yeah, that's kind of fitting. We need to go like this. Okay, just get more of my friends. And then we're going to find this place. I like this. Being empowered by my most favorite attack. That's fun. Yeah, if I would have known that it's that they have like another of those lusts, I could have used them all the time, but now I don't know if I can even get into it anymore. Because I'm kinda bad at the rethinking stuff. But anyway. Yeah. We have a lot of those dudes here. And some Bloodsworn, of course. You know, I feel mighty and powerful.
That skill's not ready.
Maybe we reskill at some point before we... Yeah, maybe before I go to the... DLC areas, maybe before that I reskill a bit. Because I'm not that happy. Lightning, exploding stuff, whatever they enchanted my weapon with. Hotel, and that's the place, right? Kevin's chosen don't like us. Nice, we have the order. Okay. Oh, not a rift gate, sorry. That's what I'm looking for. Codex Winner. Here. Port Heron, yeah. Okay, all right. Good. Good! We're on the right way. Wasn't that sure anymore. Yeah, we have been here. Remember. I've been here already and we basically defeated them completely, but because of that they've ended the game in between, of course, it's not anymore. But it's more interesting that this material that seemed to be here we didn't find. Why? What does the... does this order have to do with them? There's a material here. Some kind of threat? What does this order have to do with them? I don't understand why the Hyman's Chosen want to have to do anything with the material. What's their connection? I don't really understand that. I like how strong we are, though. But yeah, I think I am going to rethink the whole, the whole skill and stuff that I use for the moment that I'm going to enter the DLCs. Then I will completely rework everything. I think that makes sense. I don't really understand though where this person should be, because we were at Port Heron before. Didn't find any material here. Is there like some secret area or some stuff like this that we didn't see? Pretty strong, that's for sure. Kill all of our dudes. Excuse me. Where might this material be? Don't see any hint of any material here. They maybe already killed it here. We would find the essence now. Now we're all over the place, but there isn't anything in Fort Heron. I don't understand. Not this one. Not this one. Northeast of Bloodgrove near Fort Heron. Ah, it's not directly in Fort Heron, it's close to Fort Heron. Ah, okay. We need to find a place that is close to Fort Heron, but not Fort Heron itself. I see, okay. But at least we found some more dynamite. That's useful. Sorry for wasting the time. Was it on the other side? Is it here maybe? That could be. There's something that we didn't check out yet. I'm sorry we have to find this place. And I'm not exactly sure where. I'm just running around a bit until we find it. I would explain why I didn't have it yet, or why I didn't fight the Satyri yet, if it's that place. Because we weren't there yet. It's against the material place. Maybe there we learned finally how to pass the material, shit. That is there. I like this. Can I keep this enchantment? That makes sense. It could be here. Here's at least a lot of material activity. So I wonder why we haven't been here yet. Where can I... Oh, here. Okay. Ooh. Maybe because of all the green shit. Not much fun. What is this place? How am I supposed to get along with that? Like, it's not easy. It's not like you can just walk through it, that's it. See the crystal door. Now we're back in the black door. Okay. I guess we have to go there, yeah. I'm just not sure how you're supposed to survive that. Basically, you can stop in different places on the way. You can drink a lot of potions and stuff, but still. Void marked. Players experience slowed casting, but are more resistant to chaos, okay. Ooh, I don't like this at all. doesn't much care for his enemies. They are not much of a problem. But this Eater stuff is.
Can't do that yet.
It takes really a lot of our life. Hey, that's not much fun. Can just drink like a ton of this mending tonics. And a ton of Aether crystals. Maybe I didn't see that there's like some potion or something that helps us going through all this stuff. I'm not that sure. Maybe there is and I just didn't see it. Could be. Could absolutely be. I'm not that smart with stuff like this. Didn't spend any time in the crafting system here at all. That's maybe a big mistake. Okay. We are through the worst of this thing. This looks the way. That's the lady we're supposed to kill. Noveria Stonefire. She goes. More dynamite. That's nice. We really have to check out the blacksmith if we can craft anything that helps us against this stuff. Now that it comes up so often. In the beginning it was only a bit, but now we have it so much. There must be something we can do. Whoa. Must be something we can do against this stuff. Wow. Excuse me? Ho. Phew. That wasn't fun. Good thing we have so many potions. Okay, I think we poured out of here. I don't really want to walk through the stuff again. But yeah, we really have to check if there's anything that helps us against this ethereal stuff. Okay, let's do port. Go back to the place of the Soul Bastion. Give up the quest and okay. Better check now the time, and we're already a bit over. And whew, after all this trouble, I think yeah, that's the episode for today. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you are in good moods. I hope you have an amazing time, and we only see each other in Grimdawn again in the next year, so I wish you an amazing start into the new year, an amazing New Year's Eve. Have fun with your friends and loved ones, and yeah, let's hope everything gets better next year. Thank you very much for watching. I hope next year we grow the channel a bit, we have a bit more fun, more amazing adventures, and I can't thank you enough for everything. So, have an amazing time, take care of yourselves, and see you next year. Bye!